I'm Greg with Greger Group Real Estate here in Austin, Texas. So many people have been reaching out wanting to buy homes because they've heard about how low the interest rates are and what a great time it is for them to get into a mortgage. And one of the questions we're hearing the most is, are there any first-time homebuyer programs or any kind of down payment assistance programs that they can be a part of? We're bringing in Amy Ayler, a trusted lender of ours, so we can ask her a couple questions about what programs are out there and how you can get your hands on some of this assistance. Make sure you watch through till the end because we're gonna tell you the one thing that you need to do right now if you're thinking about buying a house. Like always, if you have any questions about real estate, just reach out. I'm happy to answer any questions we can help with. Thanks for joining me today, Amy. Just to introduce you guys who haven't seen some of the mortgage videos she's done with us in the past, this is Amy Ayler with the Big Life Home Loan Group, and she's been one of our preferred lenders for years. And a big part of that is because, you know, she's just always been so good about talking to our clients and working with them with their situation and figuring out what can be good opportunities for them. Thanks for being here.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Of course, of course. We've had a lot of people asking us about first-time homebuyer programs for financing.
Absolutely. So not only for first-time homebuyers, mm-hmm. But you can be a second or third homebuyer. So there are down payment assistance programs for both. And okay. There's grants and loans available to pretty much everybody in the state of Texas.
Okay. So you're saying that there are ones that are specific to first-time home buyers, but even if you're not, then there are other programs.
Yes, there's typically something for everybody.
What would you say is one of the more common down payment assistance programs that people will qualify for?
Yeah. So in Texas, there's TSHAC, which is Texas State Affordable Housing Corporation, and then TDHCA, which is the Texas Department of Housing. Those are probably the most common.
Okay.
They'll dictate the rate though. So depending on how much you need, whether it be 3, 4, 5, or 6%, because mm-hmm. they don't always cover down payment assistance, they'll actually cover some of your closing costs. So depending on how much you need, will dictate the interest rate that will be available for that program. And then in the city of Austin, mm-hmm. there's Austin DPA. The rate is already assigned by the lender for either an FHA or conventional program, but the city of Austin will give up to $14,999.
Wow.
They have tighter restrictions with location of property and income, but it's also a great program that we explore.
Okay. You mentioned that there are different rates depending on how much down payment. What would a buyer expect for a rate to be compared to like what everyone sees for a normal 30-year mortgage rate?
Well, right now, they're probably, so for the FHA program getting 3 or 4% down payment assistance, the interest rate is about 3/8 or 0.375% higher than a program without down payment assistance.
Okay.
So right now they're quoting rates of about 3.125%.
Yeah.
For an FHA with down payment assistance, when really we're probably sitting closer to about 2.75.
Okay.
So there is that 1/4 to 3/8 point different. And then on the grant program, if you're using it with a conjunction of a conventional program, mm-hmm. those are about 3.75. So they're
a little higher.
Okay. So whenever I talk with a client, I want to make certain, one, that they have a plan B option, maybe being a gift from a relative. And we want to show them the pros and the cons of using down payment assistance versus not. Most of the time, the pros are much greater than cons. The rates are still incredibly low, so it's definitely something to explore.
Okay. I know you mentioned with the grant programs that there's a higher rate. So with the one with the lower rate, is that not a grant? Does that mean you have to pay that back?
Not necessarily. If you stay inside, if you keep the home within 9 years, it's mm-hmm. forgivable. If you were to sell the home prior to 9 years, there is a recapture, but it's going to be very low because not only does your home have to appreciate extensively, but so would your household income. So you've kind of seen like a regular trajectory of income and your home has moderate to a little high appreciation, the recapture may be zero. So although they say there could be possibly be a recapture, it's very highly unlikely that you would have to pay anything. So even the loans technically can be grants.
Okay. So yeah, especially if you know you're going to live in there for a while, you know, I guess you said 9 years, then you don't have to worry about repaying those.
Yeah. After 5 years, because that's usually the time that most people sell, that's the highest point of recapture. And then it starts going down. But again, your income would have to go up quite significantly for you to have to pay any recapture at all. And clearly they'll never come in. Like when you sell your home, they would never come in and take, you know, 50% of your appreciation or anything like that. They would take a percentage of what you netted from the sale as that recapture. So it's not like something out of pocket that you would be paying. It would be coming from the proceeds of your sale and it'd be a low percentage.
I see. Do these down payment assistance programs, do they cover closing costs as well?
Yeah, so you can get up to 6% down payment assistance. That helps for both your 3.5% down if you're going plus the rest can go towards your closing costs. So absolutely.
So, okay. So potentially you could actually get a home without bringing anything to the closing table.
Sure. And then if you were in the city limits of Austin and you qualified for the City of Austin down payment assistance, it could potentially cover your down payment and closing costs completely because it's up to $14,999.
Wow.
And you can also do, if you qualify for the City of Austin, you could also marry that program with a TSHAC or TDHCA down payment assistance. So you can do more than one program. I would say the most popular asked is probably the 5% down payment assistance because it typically covers the down payment plus their closing costs.
I see. Are people able to use this program in the seller market and get offers accepted?
Yeah, for sure. Because this program with TSHAC and TDHCA, these state programs, they allow our underwriters to underwrite the file. So we're not sending off a package to the state for approval. The closing turnaround time is exactly the same. We handle everything in-house. It's a simple registration of the loan.
I see. So the seller never even knows that you're doing any kind of down payment assistance because it all happens in the background.
Correct. The only time that they would know is with the City of Austin. Typically, if we're going to prepare and set proper expectation, if someone uses the City of Austin down payment assistance, we're going to set expectation for a 45-day close.
Got it. Okay. Are there any downsides to people using down payment assistance programs?
You know, I really don't think so. I mean, yes, I would say there are sometimes cons if the potential buyer has the ability to get gift funds from a relative. Or they'll be able to capture a lower interest rate because they're not needing the grant or the down payment assistance from the state.
Yeah.
But most of the time, no. If you look at their cost of savings, if they're currently renting, because a lot of people cannot purchase without a little assistance.
Yeah.
And so if you start looking at their renting versus owning and their cost savings, then it makes sense every single time.
Yeah. Yeah. Renting very often, you're just kind of burning money if you can actually buy instead. What haven't I asked about down payment assistance programs or first time home buyer programs that might be helpful?
When we do our pre-app interview, we need to ask the appropriate questions up front so that we can kind of zone in on what programs would be applicable, because not every down payment assistance program is applicable for every buyer. The other thing is we want to know what their credit score is, because they're going to have minimum credit score requirements for these down payment assistance programs. 640, they have kind of loosened up and gone to 620. it's really important for the lender to have a very detailed pre-app and even post-app interview with the buyer, because we can't assume that the buyer knows what they want or what's available to them. Most of the time, they don't even know. Most of the time, they assume that they have to have a large down payment. Mm-hmm. Most of the time, they assume still, even to this day, that they even have to have 20% down to go conventional. So yeah. It's our job to kind of see what the consumer knows and what they don't. And being in the industry for 30 years, there's definitely things they don't know that we're here to educate them on.
So if somebody out there watching this maybe doesn't think they have enough for a down payment, but is interested in potentially buying a house, what do you think their first step should be?
Talk to a lender. I'm going to tell someone that they're going to need to have that pre-app interview. And if the moment someone starts thinking about purchasing a home, even if we're sitting here in November and they think it's something that they want to do in the spring of next year, they need to talk to a lender. Talking with me, I'll let them know right off the bat, do they need to apply now or can they wait? With credit, some people are quite surprised that, you know, there's this medical collection or there's this collection on their credit report. I will tell you every single time, people will tell me that their credit score is higher than what it actually is for a couple reasons. One, if they get a general inquiry from Experian.com or Karma.com or whatever, those are general inquiries. Those are not FICO scores. And when pulling credit for mortgage purposes, they use a different algorithm. So it's very common for your credit score to be 20, even 30 points lower when pulled by a mortgage loan company. What people typically think is that, oh, this mortgage lender pulled my credit and it dropped my score. No, we did not drop your score. It's just a different algorithm. It's a true FICO score. And so rather than assume, we need to go ahead and see where you stand now, because oftentimes I get people in a better purchasing position for the spring. And me pulling credit now and me repulling credit in March is not going to negatively impact you. If anything, I can improve your interest rate by helping you maybe work on some situations that you didn't know about. Maybe you're at 600, but how could I get you to 640? So you do qualify for down payment assistance.
Yeah.
How can I get you a higher credit score so that you do have lower mortgage insurance premiums and all of that? So I would just say, if someone thinks that they want to do something within the next 6 to 12 months, talk to a lender. Based on the conversation that I have with the consumer, I let them know, go ahead and apply now, or they can apply later.
Yeah.
So we want to try to just let people know where they stand based off their base income or their current situation and what they're getting. See, your dog wants to get a house too. So
I know.
Why?
home office fun, right? Crying babies, barking dogs, people running around.
Absolutely.
I really want to thank you, Amy, for joining us today and giving us all this knowledge. For anyone watching, really, if you're interested in buying a house, one of the first steps is to talk to a lender. If you have a trusted lender, reach out to them. You've been so generous with your time, Amy. If somebody wanted to reach out to you, what's the best way to do that?
Now, if people email the team, the first thing that I want to do is schedule a call. And basically, I see my job is giving you a roadmap on how to buy a home. So whether it's now or later makes no difference to me.
Thank you, Amy.
All right. Thank you.
All right. Bye.
Bye.